For today's logo design tutorial, stay tuned to the very end because I'm going to give you a test or quick quiz on the material in the video itself. So learn some key and essential techniques of logo designing Illustrator that you're going to find useful as a graphic designer. Something else useful to you as a graphic designer is Skillshare, which hosts over 25,000 classes throughout the entirety of the online learning community. You can learn useful techniques and skills for graphic design, logo design, and much, much more. Skillshare is also super affordable, but today I have a special offer for the first 500 people who sign up to Skillshare, as they will receive a free trial of Skillshare Premium for 2 months. Check out Skillshare, link down below. Now the first technique today is to do with color. When we have a logo design, or pretty much any design for that matter in Illustrator, for working on print, we normally have the color picker set to CMYK. Now what if I actually want to lower the brightness, or heighten the brightness, or maybe drop the saturation a little bit? That's quite difficult to do using the CMYK sliders. Say for example, I want to make the same color purple a little bit brighter. It's kind of difficult. So instead, head into the fly down menu and select the HSB color values. These stand for hue, saturation, and brightness. Now at the top, we can toggle the hue left and right, but more importantly, we can adjust the saturation and the brightness, which can really help to adjust your designs in terms of their saturation or brightness. You can easily make monochrome designs using this, and it's also something I use for my logo designs when I'm experimenting with color and different tones. So yeah, don't always stick to CMYK or RGB. The HSB method is actually really useful. Now the second tip today in Illustrator for logo designing involves the grid. Now I know many of you, and myself included, we do like to use grids for graphic design, especially logo design. Now the problem you might face when using the grid is that when you go to design a logo on there, you might think that you're lining up your vector paths along the grid lines precisely, when in fact, if you take a closer look, you're pretty far off. Now this is probably because you don't have the snap to grid setting activated in the view drop-down menu. After activating the setting, and when you go back to draw your pen tool path lines, you will see and feel how well the vector path snaps to the grid. When you take a closer look, you will notice that it perfectly aligns along the grid. And yes, this also works for shapes too. Resizing shapes and generating them will all conform to the grid. Also, you can enter into outline mode by pressing Command or Control Y on your keyboard, and there will still be the main larger sections of the grid present for you to see. Now the third technique or tip for logo designing is a quick pointer to a specific way you might want to design your logos. And that is the draw inside function that many people don't even know exists. So let's make a circle here and you're going to find at the bottom of the color palette, the draw inside option. So now whenever you take the brush tool for example, or the pen tool, anything you draw will actually be enclosed in that shape. And this is a quick way to make some neat designs for, you know, a potential logo design. And it might even be the way the dribble logo was created, if you take a look at that logo for yourself. Now moving on to the fourth of five tips in today's video on logo design techniques, I have to remind you all of compound paths. Yeah, I know I've talked about them before on my channel. It's something that many designers underestimate, and especially for logo designing. So if I make a compound path of these two shapes here, cutting the wolf head into the circle, I've actually made the incision into the shape itself. But the cool thing about compound paths is that I can take the group selection tool and then click on my design and then press V, and I can actually move around, scale, and adjust the shape inside of the other shape. Using the Pathfinder option doesn't allow this, and this is why it's an awesome non-destructive way of working with your logo designs. Also, you can release the compound path when you're finished as well. Now, the last technique or tip when designing Illustrator is to use the outline mode. Now, this is especially useful when you have different design elements of the same color. Just press Command or Control Y to enter into outline mode, and then you can see your design with precision. And say, for example, if I want to bring my design up to the circle edge, I can do that properly and completely precise with the outline mode. So now, after you've heard the five techniques for logo designing, it's time to test your knowledge and your attention spans in this last part of the video. So, in the Illustrator Color Picker, what does HSB stand for? The answer, of course, was Hue, Saturation, and Brightness. Where is the Snap to Grid setting in Adobe Illustrator? It's located under the View top drop-down menu. Where is the Draw Inside option located within Adobe Illustrator? You can find this just below the color palette, which was bottom left of my screen. Now, what color scheme did I say was easy to make using the HSB sliders? Monochrome is the correct answer, and it's a lot of fun making monochrome designs using those sliders. Which selection tool did I use to move objects around after making a compound shape? The answer here was the group selection tool. What is the keyboard shortcut for the outline mode in Adobe Illustrator? This one's pretty easy, so you should all get it, and that is Command or Control Y. And lastly, what is the main reason for using a compound path on a logo design? The answer is, it's a non-destructive workflow method, and it allows you to make edits to the design later in the workflow. Now remember, if you want to join the Skillshare community of over 7 million creators, check out Skillshare down in the description box below, where the first 500 people to sign up are going to receive 2 months free of Skillshare Premium. So there is today's 5 techniques or tips for logo designing, and I do have many more tips and many more techniques in previous videos for logo designing. Subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content, and turn on the notifications so you never miss an upload. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.